Hi, it's Dwyer, gamblersadvisory.com, dwyervip.com. Look us up in the sports section on Roku. We're there. The vanity code, one word, is Dwyer Boxing News. The name of that channel is Dwyer Boxing and Sports News. On iTunes, one word, Dwyer Boxing News. Remember, the opinion you should follow should be your own. Just consider this video to be a second opinion from a complete stranger online. Now, longtime subscribers know that in general, right now, at this moment, I'm really not that impressed with most heavyweights, right? I think the heavyweight division right now isn't where it should be, right? I don't see the vivacious, young, menacing heavyweights out there that really would raise eyebrows. In other words, I don't see a Mike Tyson on the horizon. As I said in an earlier video, it looks to me like Vladimir Klitschko conceivably could reign for several more years. That's if he wants to spend his time in the boxing ring into his 40s, right? But understand, some of the younger guys, Deontay Wilder, really doesn't impress me that much. Right, he seems to me to be a long right hand from distance. I don't see anything else. Right? Other American heavyweights, Brian Jennings. I feel more strongly in Jennings than I do Deontay Wilder, but Brian Jennings, to be blunt, didn't really impress me late in his fight against Mike Perez. Right? I do have questions about Jennings' awareness in the ring. Right? Well, let me say this. Also, some other heavyweights. Bermain Stiverne, big puncher. I actually like his back foot game quite a bit. The problem is he has the same problem, in my opinion, that Joe Lewis had. He's very slow-footed. I get the feeling another fighter could dissect him from outside and move away from him. Right? If Stiverne doesn't land that big punch, and if you're not in his face like Chris Areola got in his face, right, then Stiverne might not be able to catch up to you. Right? People know Derek Chisora. I view Derek Chisora as limited. Right? Front foot, predictable, punches a little bit too wide. Right? David Haye, is he still boxing? Right, I think Haye has talent. The problem is David Haye really is on the sidelines of late. Also, David Haye did get his crack at Vladimir Klitschko. Vladimir Klitschko conceivably could avoid David Haye, especially since Haye's not doing enough to become a mandatory contender, right? And no one writing a biography on Vladimir Klitschko years from now could accuse him of ducking David Haye, right? Anthony Joshua, I know there's a lot of buzz about him. He looks extremely green to me. I'm very curious to see if he can get a stoppage in his next fight against Kevin Johnson, a guy who went the distance against Vitaly Klitschko, a fighter I consider to be much better than Anthony Joshua. Joshua, at this point, seems to be a young knockout artist. I'm not sure if the rest of the recipe is there to bake the cake. Right? Only time will tell. People know what I think about David Price. Tony Thompson's had two shots at Vladimir Klitschko. Should have won the first one, quite frankly. Got blown out in the second one, right? Seemed to, you know, lose stamina against Kubrat Pulev. Did beat Adlinair Solis. I'm looking forward to that rematch when it happens. Solis is one of the few guys I think might have the talent to actually become heavyweight champ. But Solis, of late, hasn't looked inspired. Right? So for me, really, at this stage, the heavyweight division boils down to really four guys. Right? Let me say this, too. Shannon Briggs, you've got to be kidding. Right? You know, beating up truck drivers isn't a way to become a mandatory contender. Don't stalk the champ unless you've done something to be a credible opponent. Right? The last time Shannon Briggs was in a heavyweight championship fight for a legitimate title, he got destroyed by Vitaly Klitschko. Quite frankly, that fight should have been stopped with several rounds to go. Right? I'd like to see Shannon Briggs rehabilitate himself against some other elite heavyweights. Right? You know, to earn his way back into the ring, he hasn't earned it yet. And I haven't seen anything in the ring from Shannon Briggs that would suggest to me that he's even ready for anything resembling a heavyweight title fight. So for me, the heavyweight division really boils down to Vladimir Klitschko, obviously. Right? Bermain Stiverne, okay, maybe. Stiverne definitely has the punch, right? He definitely outboxed Chris Arreola, although I believe Klitschko could just move away from him and win that fight easily, right? We'll put Brian Jennings in the mix, right? Tyson Fury belongs in the mix. I guess there are more than four guys. But one of the guys who has to be included in the equation. And I mean, this guy needs to be included ahead of people like Anthony Joshua, right? Deontay Wilder, Malik Scott, right? One of the guys who has to be included is Antonio Tarver, right? I would argue that, you know, it's either Tarver or Brian Jennings as to who's the best American heavyweight right now, right? I wouldn't put Deontay Wilder in the conversation, right? There is a long shot out there. Andy Ruiz, I encourage people to look at his career. I would put Andy Ruiz over Deontay Wilder. Now, I understand I'm in the minority. I understand I'm a voice in the wilderness, but understand at 46 years old, Antonio Tarver dissected the trainer for Vladimir Klitschko last night, Jonathan Banks, right? That left hand is laser-like. More importantly, he has a resume that guys like Deontay Wilder or Brian Jennings can't come close to duplicating right now, right? He's now fighting at a weight, heavyweight, where he wouldn't have to cut weight like he did to fight Danny Green, right, for the cruiserweight title. He poses angles that would give certain fighters a very hard time, right? I think Tarver, for example, would dismantle Deontay Wilder. I know Wilder's unbeaten with a 100% KO ratio. Put me among those who would take the old man. Understand, Tarver isn't trying to get by on a lot of movement and a lot of hand speed. Rather, he's trying to get by on the same things that Juan Manuel Marquez and Bernard Hopkins are trying to get by on. And that's timing. That's defense. He has exactly the kind of style that would age well. You understand? So, 46 years old, maybe that would be too old for a Mike Tyson type style. Tyson's a guy whose defense consisted of upper body movement, right? Tarver's defense consists of him, southpaw, being in front of you at such an angle where he knows you can't hurt him with your right hand. He knows you'll have problems touching him with your left jab. He knows how to neutralize speed, right? He fought Roy Jones 3 times, right? He certainly won the last 2 of the 3. There's a question on who really won that first match. I understand Jones had lost weight to get back down to light heavy. But understand, Tarver is real at heavy at 46 years old. I believe you need to take him over most of the heavyweights out there, right? He wants to be heavyweight champion. He's a serious threat. Understand, if Vladimir Klitschko can't land his left jab on Tarver, because Tarver, of course, has spent his career dodging left jabs, And if Vladimir Klitschko opens up on Antonio Tarver, what he's going to find is a fighter who knows exactly how to pinpoint a straight left hand. Right? A fighter who wants you to open up because he's a technician and he knows how to get things done. As you look at the film of the Jonathan Banks fight from last night, and it's up here, what I want you to do in that seventh round is I want you to notice how Tarver, right before he throws a left hand on the button, and when I mean on the button, you see my face? It hits Jonathan Banks right here. Is I want you to notice the right hook that he throws right before the left hand. He comes in, he throws a right hook. It's a perfect combination. He throws a right hook, right? Banks drops his hand a little bit because he sees the right hook coming. Then Tarver's up on him. Straight left hand. Understand, Banks is a righty. Tarver is able to shorten the distance and be up on him on the money with the punch. I want you to understand the power behind the punch. You know what they say. Power's the last to go. Understand, when Banks falls down, he falls down face first. He's so dazed and confused. Look at how he falls into the ropes. It's face first. The rope pulls him up. I believe his shoulder hits the rope. Folks, that fight's over, because when Banks gets back up, he can't defend himself in the slightest. Now understand, this is the trainer for Vladimir Klitschko. Understand, Banks hadn't lost. Well, put it this way, Banks hadn't been knocked out for 6 years. He lost to Seth Mitchell in the rematch, right? But understand, Seth Mitchell, big puncher, couldn't drop Banks. Here, Banks is dropped by a punch that literally is right here. That's how good the setup is with Tarver, right? What I want you to also do is to look at the ending of Tarver, Danny Green. He dominates that fight. Then what I want you to do is to look at how Green can't find the angle. Look at how Tarver is bouncing around him. Right? That's what Tarver does to righties. Look at all the righties lined up in the heavyweight division right now. Right? You don't have this kind of smooth southpaw. Now, I would take Tyson Fury over Tarver, because Tyson Fury's ambidextrous, and Tyson Fury can fight southpaw against the southpaw, has height and length, right? He can force Tarver to move around the ring. But let's get real here. What other heavyweight right now can do that? Right? Really? You know, so keep an eye on Antonio Tarver. I believe he's a payday waiting to happen. In other words, I believe if he fights most of these younger lions, Las Vegas is going to make him an overwhelming underdog. Right? The casinos are going to probably look at his age, 46 years old, look at his inactivity. He hasn't been in the ring for a while. Right? And they're going to not quite grasp the fact that he has far more skills than a Deontay Wilder. And if Wilder is expecting to come in and land that predictable straight right hand against a master like this, he's going to have problems doing so. Right? Understand, Tarver's already been in the ring with guys like Roy Jones multiple times. Bernard Hopkins. I know he lost to Hopkins, but the point is he fought Hopkins. Right? Just understand, Tarver's been in the ring with Danny Green. Right? Also understand, too, that as you get older and as your body gets a little heavier, it might be a good thing that Tarver now doesn't have to cut weight to drain himself. Right? You know, when you're older and you have to cut weight to make weight, that hurts your punch resistance. Now Tarver can come in the ring as heavy as he wants to be because he's fighting at heavyweight. You're going to notice Tarver looks heavy against Jonathan Banks. I'm guessing that's probably going to help further in getting longer odds for Tarver because people are going to look at him and they're going to say, this isn't the light heavyweight I used to know. This isn't Tarver from the Olympics. By the way, it's been so long. I believe Tarver was in the 96 Olympics. Look it up. Right? They're going to say, Tarver looks out of shape. Don't make that mistake. I'd take Tarver over Deontay Wilder today. I'd certainly take Tarver over Malik Scott today. Right? I'd take Tarver over most American heavyweights today. I'd take Tarver over Shannon Briggs today. Antonio Tarver isn't that far removed from being a legitimate challenger for the heavyweight title. Folks, I hope you're listening in the UK. I'd take Tarver over Joshua today. Keep an eye on Antonio Tarver's career going forward. He's a real threat to the crown. Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Let me add this too. I have a pay site here on YouTube, and I actually made a prediction on this video. I know most don't realize it on this fight. I know most don't realize it, and I was wrong on the prediction. Right? I'm just coming clean here. I actually, not that I thought Banks was going to win, but I thought the fight would go over. Right? I thought there would be inactivity in this fight, and there was for the first several rounds. Right? But I have to say, Tarver's punching power at heavyweight is commendable. Looking at the replay of the fight, I'm surprised Tarver was able to close the show as convincingly as he does in the seventh round. Right? You look at the fight, you realize he's just trying to set up that left hand. Right? Don't sleep on Tarver's power. Let me also talk about Tarver's stamina. Before this fight, he fought Latif Coyote. Right? As the announcer correctly points out during this telecast, to get the draw against Coyote, Tarver had to dominate the second half of the fight. So understand, Tarver has shown stamina, even at 46 years of age. And he has shown power. Right? I hope you give this fight a look. I hope you take this man seriously. Tarver's not sticking around for the paydays. He's sticking around for the title. And I'm telling you, if you look at the styles, right? Vladimir Klitschko, heavily reliant on a left jab. When he fights southpaws, he has to open up. Right? He opens up. Is opening up a good idea against Antonio Tarver ever? That's the question that needs to be asked. I'll tell you what. Jonathan Banks really didn't open up that much. I encourage you to look at the end of this fight, understanding that Tarver wins most of the rounds before the end of the fight. Also, look at how comfortable Tarver is on his back foot. Let me hear from you. Leave your comments for me here online. Visit us at gamblersadvisory.com. Thanks for stopping by.